Hey, what's going on everybody? It's Bro, hope you're doing well, and in this video I'm going to explain how variables work in Python, so sit back, relax, and enjoy the show. If you find this video helpful, please remember to like, comment, and subscribe. Your support will help keep this channel running. Alright, let's do this. A variable is a container for a value. It behaves as the value that it contains. It's much like in algebra lessons back in the day where we had to solve for whatever value x was, and then we can reuse x and it behaved exactly as that value. Well, with programming, we can do that, plus we can assign variables of different data types. So they are not limited to just numbers, we can assign whole words, numbers, and even these things called Booleans, which are either true or false. But I'll get more in depth into data types a little bit later on in this video. So let's create a variable, and this is how to do so. We need a unique name for this variable. Let's say name. Name equals some value. Now the first data type that we'll cover is strings. A string is a series of characters. So to create a string, we can either use single quotes or double quotes in Python. And we can assign this a value of whatever your own name is. So I will assign this variable name a value of bro. Now this variable will behave exactly as if it was this value, this name, and then we can reuse this variable for something. So let's print whatever our name is, print name, and this will print whatever your name is to the console window. Now when you print your variable, make sure you don't put it within quotes, because what we're doing then is literally printing the word name, as you can see here. So if you need to use your variable for something, make sure it's not within quotes. Now we can combine our string variable with another string. So within our print statement, let's print a string literal such as hello space plus name. So we are combining strings and then we're printing the result to the console window. So this will print hello bro. Now you can actually check the data type of a variable. So I'm going to turn this line into a comment. So what you'll do is take the name of the variable, surround this with a set of parentheses, and then precede the set of parentheses with the type function. And this will print the data type of this variable to the console window. And you can see that it says class str, short for string. A string is a series of characters. A name is a good example of a string, a series of characters. So that is how to check the data type of a variable. Just use the type function. Now you can actually combine variables together as long as they're of the same data type. So let's change our name to maybe first name, and we'll create a second variable called last name. Now a common naming convention with variables, if it has two words, separate each word with an underscore. It's not necessary, but it's common practice for Python. And honestly, I sometimes forget about that, but don't tell anybody. So let's create another variable called last name. Last name equals whatever your last name is. And then let's create a third variable called full name, full underscore name. And let's combine first name plus last name. And let us display full name along with hello plus full name. Now these two names were combined together to create a whole new variable. Actually, what I think I'll do is add a space within my variable. So I'm doing a bunch of string concatenation. I'm combining the variable first name plus a space character plus last name. So the result is hello, whatever your first name and last name is. So that is a variable of the string data type. It is a series of characters. Now with strings, we cannot normally use these for any sort of math. That's where the next data type comes in. For the time being, I just turned all of these lines into comments, and we are going to move on to the int data type, short for integer. This time, let's create a variable called age, and we will assign this a value of whatever your age is. Let's just say that I'm 21. Now, when you assign a value of the int data type, make sure that it is not within quotes, because then technically it would be a string then, and you can see that the color scheme for this number actually changed. So if this was a string, we would treat it different than an int data type, because with strings, we cannot normally use them for any sort of math. So we now have a variable called age, and we can actually increase or decrease or do whatever we want with the age. Let's increase our age by 1. Let's say it's our birthday. To do so, we would say age equals age plus 1, and then let's print our age to the console window. Print age, and you can see that it says I am 22. Now there's a shorthand way of writing this. what you'll do is type age plus equals 1. So that's kind of like a shortcut, and this would work the same too. Now let's print the data type of our age variable because we can. Within a print statement, I will print the age and add my age variable to this type function, and this will print the data type of my age variable to the console window, and I will turn this line into a comment just so that it doesn't get in the way. Now if I were to print the data type of my age variable, as you can see, it is of the int data type, short for integer. It only stores a whole integer number. Now, what if this was a string? So what I'm going to do is surround my value within a set of quotes, and I will turn this line into a comment so that it does not get in the way. You can see that the data type of my age variable is now a string. And with strings, we cannot normally use them for any sort of math. So let's attempt to increase our age variable by 1. And we ran into an error. A type error can only concatenate string to string, not int. Now the point being is that it's important to use the appropriate data type, because with strings we cannot normally use them for any sort of math. You'll want to use a data type of a numeric value, an int or a float, which we'll discuss a little bit later. Now here's a situation to consider. What if we would like to display our age variable along with a string literal, much like what we did with this line involving a string literal such as hello plus the user's full name. So let's attempt to do so, and this is not going to work, and I'll explain why. So within our print statement, let's say something such as your age is plus age. Now we're going to run into a type error. That's because we attempted to use string concatenation with a string literal and a variable of a different data type, a variable of the int data type. In order to display our age along with the string, we would need to convert our age variable to the string data type. And one way in which we can do that is by typecasting, and we'll cover this more in the next video. So we're going to surround our age variable, that is of the int data type, with a set of parentheses, and precede this with str, short for string. And this will convert our variable to a string that will allow us to display it with another string. Now, if we were to run this program this way, this will now display your age is, and in this case, 22. So if you need to display a variable of a different data type along with the string, you would just need to use a string cast to convert that data type to a string. But we'll cover this more in the next video on typecasting. So that is the int data type. It stores a whole integer number. And the next data type is the float data type. And I'm going to turn these lines into comments and we can move on. Now, the float data type is a numeric value that can store a number that includes a decimal portion. An int data type cannot store a decimal portion. That's why it's int, short for integer. It only stores a whole number. This time, let's say we have a height, and I will assign this a perfectly normal height of maybe 250.5 centimeters. So this decimal portion is important. That's indicating that this is a floating point number, a float for short. So let's print our height to the console window. Print height, and this will print whatever my height is. And now let's check the type of our height using the type function. So within a print statement, I'm going to add my height, surround this with another set of parentheses, and precede this with the type function. And the data type of my variable height is a float, short for a floating point number, a numeric value that contains a decimal portion. And now for practice, let's print our height along with a string literal. So let's create a string literal such as your height is plus height. But guess what? We're going to do some typecasting. So surround height with a set of parentheses and precede this with str so that we convert height to a string so that we can use string concatenation within this print statement. And this will print the message, your height is 250.5. Actually, let's add centimeters to the end. So plus cm. And there we go. And that is what a floating point number is. Float for short. It is a numeric value that contains a decimal portion. Now, the last data type that we're going to cover is the Boolean data type. It is a variable that can only store true or false. Let's say we have a variable called human. If we were to assign this a Boolean value, this would be either true or false. And we can print whatever this value is. Let's print whatever human is, and this will display false. Now, the reason that you may want to use Booleans instead of strings, even though you can still store a string representation of the word false or true is that these are very useful when we get to if statements. We can check to see if some statement is true. So that is a good use of Boolean values. Now let's check the data type of my human variable. So let's print type human, and this will print to the console window bool, short for Boolean. Now make sure you're not putting this within quotes, because then it's technically a string and they behave differently. Now the data type is a string, and you may have noticed as well that the font color has changed between strings and Boolean values, so that's another good indicator. Now what if you need to display your value along with a string using string concatenation? Well, guess what? We're gonna typecast again. So let's print something. Are you a human? So we need to use string concatenation. So I will convert my Boolean variable of human to a string. And I have been programmed to inform you that yes, I am in fact a human. That is true. Well, everyone, that is the basics of variables. It is a container for a value, and they behave as the value that they contain. There are four basic data types: strings, which store a series of characters; ints, which store a whole integer; floats, which are floating point numbers; a numeric value with a decimal; and booleans, which only store true or false, and they're very useful with if statements. So that is it for variables. If you would like a copy of all this code, I will copy and paste all of this to the comments section down below. But yeah, that is how variables work in Python. Hey you, yeah, I'm talking to you. If you learned something new, then help me help you in three easy steps by smashing that like button, drop a comment down below, and subscribe if you'd like to become a fellow bro.